And we're back, boys.
Thank you.
Thank you. am I? Was it you who called me here? I intended to come. The fault is mine. Such is the burden of hope. What fool would relinquish his weapon on the eve of battle? That which I do is no different from that which you have done so many times, Warrior of Darkness. I arm myself, I hone my skills, I make ready to vanquish my enemy, you. You who have murdered my brothers, who have taken their selfless labors in service to the one true world and turned them to ash. I see you for what you are. You are death, and only in death shall you serve any purpose. The Convocation charged me to steer mankind and the very star upon their true course. As Elidibus, it is my duty, and I shall see it done. I will strike you down. Destroy you, body and soul. All else must wait. Ere long, I will come for you, Warrior of Darkness. And I will save the world. One last matter. I bore witness to your final struggle with Emetzelk. It seemed as if he saw something familiar in you. As if he mistook you for another. No. I recall not of whom he spoke. Mayhap I never knew you, or mayhap it is another fragment lost.
Ah, I wasn't aware you already had a guest. If the conversation is constructive, I shall not intrude. But if you seek to stir up trouble, Elidibus, then I must insist you leave at once.
Though you lack her blessing, your soul is surprisingly dense.
Worry not. I seem to be unharmed. This is my own doing. The consequence of my recent exertions. It is the Tower's way of compensating me for the demands I have placed on it. Rest assured, it is no great inconvenience at present. Indeed, I told Beck Lug as much, but they would not be persuaded and sent me away to rest. No need to make a fuss. Strange as it may sound, I consider it something of a badge of honor. One of the brave souls who saw me delivered unto the first once said that the world shall ever have a place for tales of heroism so long as we have need of inspiration in our lives. Though he and his fellows had no way of knowing whether their mad scheme would amount to anything, they knew that the attempt alone would inspire hope. Or so they hoped. A more optimistic lot one would be hard-pressed to find. They said they would find a means to save our God's forsaken world, just as soon as they had sent me on my way. Said it with such confidence that, for a fleeting moment, I half believed them. Such faith, such courage in the face of unrelenting despair. For a long time, it was more than I could bear to remember them. But having come this far, having sent full many on their way myself, I see things more clearly. To take action is to hope. To believe, to choose to believe, is to take the first step towards a brighter future. And why do I tell you this? Because I want you to indulge me in a little recklessness. Needless to say, I have a plan. And when all is said and done, I will ask yet another favor of you.
You're both here. Oh, thank goodness.
What's wrong?
It's Thancred. He's collapsed. Excuse us. This way. I would rather you hadn't seen this. I'm sorry. We have urgent tidings. Oh, no. No, I'm not angry with you. On the contrary, I know full well how hard everyone has been searching for a way to return home. And I had hoped to afford you the time you needed. But given our friend's present state, perhaps it was for the best that you came. Stiff and cold, all of them. As if they were made of wax, barely alive at all.
And they had been doing so well. Save for occasional signs of etheric instability, they appeared to be in passable health. Then, quite without warning, things took a turn for the worse. A change for which even Master Matoya could offer no explanation. She could only remind me that the soul is yet an unknown frontier, and that much and more lies beyond our ken. But let's not lose heart just yet. At times like these, it is all the more important that we remain positive. Why? I but this moment succeeded in quelling a fluctuation in Thancred's ether. And while the others have weakened, they have remained relatively stable. I believe I may leave my post for a moment. So come, let me hear your tale outside. Thank you.
Forgive the delay.
We have visited every region and confirmed the presence of Asians throughout the realm.
Lest a grave predicament be made to seem hopeless, it should be noted that they are of inferior rank. The black masked minions who answer to the red.
Yes, a gaggle of schemers attempting to exploit recent events to sow the seeds of petty conflict. Fortunately, nothing of any great concern has come of their meddling just yet.
We also encountered a number of the Crystarium's former defenders, busily solving this problem and that in a bid to become Warriors of Light.
Their zeal is to be applauded. It is but a pity I cannot encourage them on their course.
Not knowing Elidibus set them upon it, no. Both the troubles to be solved and the villains to be vanquished are his doing too, like as not. And so, with apologies to the aspiring Warriors of Light, I believe it best that we deal with the Asians quickly and quietly.
I quite agree.
But tell us, what news from the source? How fare our bodies? Oh dear. Then we must redouble our efforts. Not that we've ever stinted in that regard.
This would seem an appropriate moment to ask about the spirit vessel. Tell me you've made some progress.
We have, as it happens. One moment.
The red stones. Then this doth mean...
For the benefit of all, permit us to explain. As you will recall, using white aurasite as our starting point, we fashioned a vessel for mind and memory both. Yet, though it served this purpose admirably, the process of imbuing it with one's complete essence proved a somewhat thornier proposition. Simply put, the memory would not accompany the mind. And so, we looked to the Allegan's mastery of memory transference for a solution.
This approach was not without its own complications, however, relying as it does upon blood, which inanimate objects notably do not possess. We duly explored methods of suffusing the vessel with drops of the aforementioned. Alas, our painstaking experimentation succeeded only in making me feel faint, and singularly failed to imbue the crystal with the necessary properties. It was then that an idea occurred to me, namely that we might fuse the vessel not with normal blood, but with my crystallized essence.
You're doing this for our sakes. So far be it from us to complain. But don't think we haven't noticed what's happening to your arm.
It falls well short of offering up my life in exchange for yours, which was your only stipulated prohibition, as I recall. And it is but a small price to pay for delivering you home.
Assuming it works, we shall soon know if this grisly addition will serve as a suitable conduit for the subject's memory, though not soon enough to warrant your waiting. The test is like to take a while.
Let us be off then. We have Asians to attend to, among other things.
Forgive me, but I count 6 vessels, and there are only 5 of us.
One is for testing purposes. I will personally use it to see whether the crystal functions as it should.
And if it does, wouldn't that mean that your soul could also return to the source?
Yes. In theory, at least. But there is a distinct difference between your circumstances and mine. While your corporeal forms want for souls, my past self does not. Mayhap our essences would blend, or mayhap they would... Colonel, there is no telling what might occur.
And you'd be willing to take that risk?
I would.
I see.
Thank you.
Excellent. I had intended to speak with you alone. None of my doing, lest you misunderstand. The link between our body and soul wavers. I know not what you hoped to find here, but it will avail you naught to learn of our past. Fades away into oblivion. Does the world no longer have need of me? No, I am Elidibus, and I will fulfill my duty. Sundered though you may be, you fought for the world's salvation. For hope. Hope. Ah, it swells within me, empowers me. Now I may carry out my mission. And yet, why do I yearn for this? Why do I struggle so? I shall take her into my safekeeping. If you want her back, you will do as I ask. Show me your strength. I would take your measure. I have prepared a suitable arena. You need but ride the flow of ether. You have grown stronger since last we fought. The result of your trials in the first, no doubt.
Have you finished? My apologies. I freed myself as soon as I awoke, but rather too late, I see. Now, Elidibus, if you have ceased trading blows, I would trade words with you. I have a theory, you see. One concerning that which you seek to accomplish. It stems from who, or rather what, you truly are. A primal. The ancients created Zodiac to deliver the star from destruction. If the magic that brought him forth is the precursor of what we know as summoning, then Zodiac would have been instilled with a presiding desire. I found it among the records at Anida, and it came as no surprise. Were I faced with the world's destruction, I too would wish for the same. Salvation. I know that you sacrificed yourself to become Zodiac's heart. How you came to be separated from him is less clear. But if you are a fragment of his being, it stands to reason a desire for the world's salvation would drive you. And thus did you seek to inspire the masses to rise up as warriors of light, going so far as to use Ardbert as a symbol of hope.
Correct on all counts. Such is my nature, and such are my methods. I have aided heroes. I have made them. I have even become them. This served not only to strengthen me, but also to facilitate the work of my brothers, such as Emmet Selk, with his penchant for nation building.
Then you will be all too familiar with the fickleness of mankind. We change, we forget, and what little we do remember becomes twisted and fragmented over time. For which reason you deem us unfit to carry on your legacy? But are you yourself free of these foibles? As the last witness of the final days, do you remember everything that was lost? Or even the things you cared about?
Get to the point.
A primal is shaped by the hope that fuels it. Even should this hope be something as simple as the world's salvation, it is the collective desire of innumerable disparate souls crying out for deliverance. Having drawn your strength from such a cacophony of voices, can you truly be sure you still speak with your own?
Your question is irrelevant. No matter how much I should change, no matter how much I should forget, I shall ever remember my duty. At times, I stand with my brethren. At times, I stand against them. All that I might steer mankind and the very star upon their true course. For Elidibus is my name and my mission, guiding my every deed. But enough talk. You have shown me sufficient proof of your might. As I am now, I would struggle to defeat you. Yet I have still to play all of my cards. If I could offer you some semblance of sport, your lessers would pose no threat to me. Would you not agree, warrior of darkness?
I was wondering where you'd disappeared to. Is something troubling you? No? Very well. I have everything. Let's hurry back to the surface. Forgive us our lateness. Master Chai, my congratulations on your appointment. By all accounts, you are a capable mayor.
Oh, I have capable friends, my lady. I must say, it's good to see you looking hale and whole again.
The credit for that lies with my own capable friend. Without whom, I might never have escaped my abductor.
I suppose that would explain why Elidibus has been fostering faith in the Warrior of Light. While you were enjoying your audience with the Wandering Heart of Zodiac, we were busy dispatching the last of the Black Master Ascians, a task which proved almost insultingly easy. Formidable though we undoubtedly are, they were obviously sent to provide encouragement for budding heroes. One cannot help but wonder how many times the ploy has been used before.
Master Chai, you mentioned that the people of Calusia are similarly enamored of the Warrior of Light.
Indeed, though it's hardly surprising given the state of the world. Many are still struggling to find a purpose, and it's only natural that they should take comfort in the tales.
Then the fever has spread to every corner of Norvrent. We may have dealt with his black-masked minions, but it is plain Elidibus has yet to show his hand.
Oh my! What a spectacular sky!
Another star shower.
Wait, is that? Amarot.
Oh. Hear, feel, think.
Did you hear that? That voice calling out?
No, I didn't hear anything, but... why do I feel so... like I've lost something dear to me?
Does Elidibus seek to awaken more people to the Echo with clearer visions of the final days?
Around us. More of them will appear ere long. To stay would only place innocence in harm's way. We must fight this battle elsewhere.
Wait! Take one of our airships. You can decide what to do on your flight to the Crystarium.
You are a capable leader in your own right, Master Chai. The citizens of Yulmar chose well.
It's settled then.
To the airship!
Our fates are not yet sealed.
My turn!
Here we go!
Protect you. yourself! Keep your guard up! Thank you.
I think...
Apparently even they have limits. Nevertheless, we should remain vigilant.
Uriangée, something occurred to me while we were fighting. These enemies...
Are heroes hailing from other shards, summoned hither to deliver this world from its doom. Scant moments after the star shower did they appear, as yet more souls were inspired to walk the hero's path, no doubt. Thus did hopes for salvation of realms near and far resonate and converge, lending still greater strength unto our adversary.
So that's Elidibus's game. But first things first. If the rings are the same as the Exarch's, then we need to ask him how that's possible.
The Crystarium is close. Let us press on.
They come.
So near and yet so far.
In the chaos of conflict, one can always find an opening to exploit.
Whoever taught you that is a wise man indeed, and good with a gunblade. But yes, I dare say we can create an opening wide enough for at least one of us to slip through. That being you, of course. No others are welcome to follow in your wake. Reen and I will keep our guests occupied.
Brave and selfless as ever. Yet the two of you may struggle to fool our foes, etherically sensitive as they are. Had you a comrade who could use destructive magics to wreak havoc upon the ambient ether, on the other hand?
Very well. I too shall assist in the diversionary effort.
Oh, not this old dance again.
Yes, obviously I'll stay and fight.
Alphano, I'm about to do a great many stupid and reckless things. Watch my back, would you?
There you have it. Take care of yourself, my friend.
We'll do our best.
Finished? Then let's begin.
Is done.
Oh, let me see, let me see! Oh, yes! Your memories are preserved safely within! We've done it! We've done it at last!
I have inspected the other vessels. They are all ready to receive of our friends' memories.
Familiars bear word to them at once!
Elidibus. It was not until I observed the battle between Emmet Selk and the Warrior of Darkness that I realized what I must do. I will summon heroes from other worlds unto the First, just as you did. Their presence shall serve to empower me, granting me the strength to crush my enemy.
Though it pains me to disappoint you, I feel compelled to explain that the magic in question requires no small amount of preparation.
Ah, but you assume I require my champions to be summoned in their entirety. I do not. Their souls needn't even be whole. My purpose requires no more than their burning desire to vanquish evil. This I shall sear upon the ether, raising thereby an army of phantom heroes to whom I shall whisper, as I have to so many over the ages. Here lies darkness. It must be destroyed.
And you expect me to cooperate?
I do not require your cooperation. Your death will suffice. The magic I shall have from your corpse.
Go, Lucas! We must flee!
My friend, how did you?
No matter, Elidibus. He took us unawares.
It was all we could do, to raise a ward to hinder his steps. And so we fled, but he took it. The vessel with the Exarch's memories. Forgive me.
The vessel bears not only my memories, but my blood. The blood of Allegan royalty. Granting him the means to control the tower. With it, he has performed I know not how many summonings, calling forth heroes from across the rift. And, as you can see, the burden upon the tower is beginning to tell. If you mean to face him alone, I will not allow it. Not this time. Elidibus has exploited the people's nobility, twisted their purest intentions for terrible ends, and I cannot let it stand. As Exarch, it is my duty to protect them, to to defend their hopes and dreams. So I am going to the Crystal Tower, with or without your blessing. Though, I would rather it were with. Thank you.
I joined you, but I would only be a burden. Better that I remain here with my gremlins.
I shall send help. Stay strong, my friend, and take heart. By binding Elidibus within the tower, we have done more than simply delay him. Much like our adversary, I am not wont to show my hand prematurely, but the time has come to bring my strongest card to bear. To the tower! keep climbing. Was but a matter of time. I cannot keep up with you, nor will it avail us to make a stand here. You must go on without me. Find Elidibus and stop him. Worry not, my friend. Though I am no warrior, I have learned to hold my own over the years. When first we explored this tower, you and your fellow adventurers formed the van, while I was left to follow in your wake. Suffice it to say, I was not best pleased with the arrangement. How I wished that I could join you. And now I have, here where it all began. I was right to trust in you, and the power of your legacy, of your name. To let them guide my every deed. For Elidibus is my name and my mission, guiding my every deed. But I chose not to walk them, thank the gods. Why ever would you ask me such a thing? Elidibus spoke in similar terms, you say? How curious. To answer your question, then, I made my choice for reasons which seemed obvious to me, but may not to any other. There were the expectations I placed upon myself before beginning my slumber, and the expectations of those who roused me. Of course, I had the choice to turn my back on a lot of it. But in the end, it was no choice at all. I cherish the time I spent with you and the others. What I wouldn't give to return to those halcyon days. Chasing ancient secrets, overcoming trial after trial with the aid of like-minded comrades. And what remarkable comrades they were. In such company, I felt as if I were a character in the epic tales that had stirred my heart as a boy, as if my dream had come true. It hadn't, of course, for I was no hero, neither then nor after. Though the world to which I awakened and the first were beset with myriad problems, I rarely knew how best to play my part. There was, however, one thing of which I was certain, that I could not bear to let those dear to me meet a tragic end. I'm afraid our time is up. Go! Rest assured, you haven't seen the last of me. I wouldn't dream of playing my trump card save in your presence.
Possible future. Worthless. All. Worthless as memories of the only past, fated to fray and fade into oblivion, leaving naught but a gaping void. Waking Sands. Yes, that was the place. The place I first made myself known to you and yours. The Seventh Rejoining had left the realm listing dangerously towards darkness, and events were unfolding that threatened to push it over the brink. Thus did I approach you in my capacity as emissary, thinking that you would make a useful pawn. But I was wrong. And for my misstep did Lahabrea and Emet Selk pay the ultimate price, leaving me the last of the unsundered. My remaining brethren, fragmented as they are, cannot hope to see our mission to its end. It falls to me alone. Defeat is not an option. I will strike you down. I will resurrect Lord Zodiac, and I will bring back those who sacrifice themselves to call him forth. Though it take 1,000,000 years, upon my honor as Elidibus, emissary of the Convocation of 14, I will see this done. What of it? I have my mission. I am Elidibus, and it is my duty to steer mankind and the very star upon their true course. This I swore to someone. We spoke, and I swore. What? What did I... This pain, this torment, is nothing no more than must be suffered to deliver the world from its doom. No more than any of you malformed creatures have known. Even should you lose all that is dear to you, even should it cost you your life, you bear the burden and fight on, kicking and screaming until your last breath is spent!
Aye, it's true. We've lost much and more. Known unimaginable suffering. But through it all, we never, ever forgot what was dear to us. And that's what gave us the strength to carry on.
It will not end here. Champions from beyond the rift, heed my call. The time is come to deliver your brethren from darkness. My heart's sole desire is a world free of sorrow. Join with me now in hope and prayer for the salvation of all! If you would usher in the end, then with my all shall I oppose you. As the avatar of those mortal heroes who fought unfalteringly in all their imperfection, as the warrior of light incarnate. Come, warrior of darkness, let us finish this. Making. What are you? No, it matters not. You are the enemy, and you will fall. Even should it cost me everything, I will not forsake my duty.